Hi everyone, it's Tiffany from Let's Get Scrappy, and thank you for joining me today. I have a couple projects to share with you. I challenged myself to see if I could use up all of this 6x6 paper pad, and I do have to say it was a struggle for me. It did take me a little bit. I had got this paper pad right before we went on lockdown, and I also got the sticker sheet as well as two 12x12 sheets that had cut-aparts on them. So this is my first project here, is this little mini album, and it measures 6x9. And I used rings as the spine and just tied some ribbon on the ends there, but you could cinch this, you could do pretty much anything and still get the same result. So on the cover here, I use some flowers from my stash. I die cut some leaves. And then these are from the sticker sheet and I just popped those up. And then this is a 4x6 card that I cut down a little bit to fit the front and then layered it up. And then right here's a sticker that I layered and popped up with foam tape and then just added a couple little embellishments on the side there. And then it opens up like this. So on the front here, this is just a slit that I did right here in the paper. And you can journal on this. You could put a photo, totally up to you. And then I just cut these from that 12x12 sheet and added those in there. And then this is one of the other cut aparts. And then you can add a 3x4 photo on the back of that. And then again, I had another sticker that I layered up and then popped it up with foam tape there. And then here is the next page that you can fit a photo right there. And I did layer this up quite a bit. I'm not sure why I did that, but I knew I wanted my page to be, which these pages are 5¾ by 6½. So since the decorative paper pad was only 6x6, I had to work off those measurements. So I layered with a green, an olive green from my stash, and then an off-white as well. And then you turn, and then here's the next layout, and we have a little photo mat. These all measure 4½ by 5½. And then you have another cut apart that you could fit a 3x4 photo on, and then I added a sticker right there. And then the next page, I just love this paper, it's so cute. And then this is a 3x4 cut apart, and I do have a magnet on the back of this here. And it opens up like that. And then I do have this where you can just put the photo, tuck the photo right there in a little tuck spot. And then same with underneath, this is a sticker that I put powder on the back to make it so that you can use it as a tuck spot as well. And then, oops, sorry, the next layout. This pulls out. Again, 4½ by 5½ photo mat. And then I popped up some stickers, layered them up right there. Then we have another magnet there. And this is open too, but these are from the sticker sheet. And again, I made it so that you can just use as a tuck spot, place a photo here. And then in this pocket, I had one 4x6 left at the end of all of my projects. So I just tucked it in there. I did cut it down a little bit. And then we have another photo mat and then a 3x4 cut apart there. And I did add, you know, a couple stickers. It was a challenge for me to use up as many stickers as possible. And then here on the last page, again, just added some ribbon to that one and then a 3x4 cut apart. And again, you could add a picture here or you can journal. It's great for journaling with the lines. And then I just took the branding strip at the bottom of the 12x12 sheet and cut that and popped that up as well. And then here is the back. And the back pretty much just mirrors the front. I just added a couple little stickers to the back of that. And then that's my mini album. And then you'll see the cards in another video, but at the end of everything, this is all I had left as far as what paper to work with, and then the stickers. So this measures 5 1/4 by 6, and it just ties. It's just a little folio. You can use it as a card. I just layered up a couple of the papers there. And then right here, these are just a whole bunch of the stickers. I think I want to have 5 stickers right here layered up. And then a couple of them are popped up just to add a little dimension. And then I did use some enamel dots right there. And then this opens up like that. And a little tuck spot. Again, this is from the branding strip. And then I did leave that open so you can add a photo, or you can write a message right there with a gel pen. And then a little 4x4 photo mat if you wanted to use that, or you can use that as your space to write something to somebody. So I just wanted to show you what I ended up with after all of that. So I did have still stickers left. And what I did besides the border strip, which I'll do the same thing, but I just took whatever I had left and then powdered the back of them and turned them into an ephemera. So that way I didn't have a sticker sheet that was half used, and I could either gift this to somebody or just keep it in my stash, but it's not as big as having a half empty sticker sheet. And then pretty much just that's all I have left. So I thought I did good with my little challenge I gave myself. But again, you'll see I made 4 cards, and you'll see that in another video. So hopefully you liked what you saw, and if you did, please give me a thumbs up. I would really appreciate it. And if you haven't already, I would love for you to subscribe to my channel so that way you can see future projects. Thanks for watching. Bye.